Today, we are announcing the indictment of a federal savings bank on mortgage fraud, securities fraud, and conspiracy. A federally chartered bank that has been catering to the Chinese immigrant community since 1984.
If you were going to pick on a bank, family-owned company, wedged between a couple of noodle shops in Chinatown, is about as easy a target as you could possibly pick.
When I was a lawyer, there was no bank owned by Chinese and serving the Chinese.
When I walk around here, I feel very much at home. This is a very tasty noodle shop.
That's always special. That's the butt, isn't it? The butt.
When we were children, my dad was excited about this bank he was gonna start.
We serve people who've never even dealt with the banking system before.
This whole ordeal began in 2009.
One of our loan officers stole money.
He was lying all over the place.
He was running a money laundering operation. I fired him that day.
They went straight to their regulator and they told them about it.
The DA's office started asking us questions.
Wait a minute, maybe we're the target.
If that prosecution goes through, that bank is going to go out of business.
Although this is David versus Goliath, their whole family of lawyers.
We spent a lot of time investigating and ended up absolutely convinced that the loan department was corrupt through and through.
They routinely falsified mortgage documents.
Reporters in this town were treated to this extraordinary photo opportunity, this almost Stalinist-looking chain gang.
Herded like cattle down the hallway. I've been doing this for 25 years, and I'd never seen that happen.
Mommy's worried. Papa's 80 years old. He's been up since 5:30 a.m. He has nothing to eat for dinner. Let's get you some food. Papa, you do.
This is how he is. He's very calm, and I'm like a jumping bean, so I'm always running around.
You better eat now. You are older than me, okay? You're not a young kid
Abacus Federal Savings Bank had one of the nation's lowest default rates, not the highest, one of the lowest. Frankly, if every bank had underwritten as well as Abacus, we wouldn't have had a financial crisis.
People get the wrong impression that Chinese are not law-abiding.
This case is an attack on our community. We're easy prey.
Too big to fail turns into small enough to jail, and Abacus is small enough to jail.